dangers of Maida research paper. World Journal of Pharmaceutical Research. Let me click on this. Hazards of white poison. Maida. Oh my God.
Shrikant.
Yeah, coming.
Hey, come here. I want to show you something.
See this paper, yeah? Maida is so dangerous, more than what we thought.
Yeah, I know. Maida is unhealthy, no?
Arre, it's not just unhealthy, it's dangerous also. You're so preoccupied with your phone, yeah? Just come and see this.
Achha, show me.
Ye dekh, yeah? It is so scary, yeah? They're using Alloxan to bleach Maida and it is leading to diabetes.
Oh my God.
Let's make a video on this, yeah, for Manchanmal.
Hi, I'm Sujata, an educator in biology and environmental science, a health and wellness consultant, and your host on Manchanmal. Do click on the subscribe button and press the bell icon. Do click on the subscribe button and press the bell icon.
I'm sure you're aware that maida or refined flour is used to prepare most of the commercially available food today. When I think of maida, the first foods that come to my mind are bread, cake, pasta, noodles and biscuits. Let us take the case of bread. Did you know that bread is one of the oldest man-made food since the dawn of agriculture? It is also one of the most prominent food in most parts of the world today. Just think of this. Bread is so commonplace that in the English language, the term breadwinner is synonymous with the earning member of the family. Bread making is more than 10,000 years old and it was always made using whole grain. But today, most of the bread that we get in the market is made from maida. And this change is very recent as my generation. Today, people are looking at healthy alternatives like brown bread. But most often, what we get in the market as brown bread is bread made with maida but colored brown. So today, I decided to bake a wholesome whole wheat flour bread. I'm making it in two methods, one with an oven and one without an oven. So keep watching till the end to know both methods. Here are the ingredients to make our whole wheat bread at home. So I've taken 2 cups of whole wheat flour, 1/2 cup of curd, 3/4 cup of buttermilk, 2 tablespoons of oil, I have taken groundnut oil, 1 tablespoon of jaggery powder, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, salt to taste, 1 tablespoon of sesame and 1 tablespoon of jeera. Jeera and sesame are optional. Also see that the buttermilk and curd are not cold. Bring it to a room temperature before you use it. Generally, I use yeast for baking a bread, but because of the lockdown, I've run out of yeast and so I thought let me try with baking powder and baking soda. So let's start preparing the dough for the bread. So I'm adding the whole wheat flour. First, we'll sieve this. The baking powder, baking soda, salt. After sieving, now I'm adding the jaggery powder, sesame. I'm keeping a little bit of sesame for using as a topping. Jeera or cumin. Same here, I'm keeping a little bit to use as a topping. Oil, mix this. Now I'm adding the curd, mix it. And gradually we will add the buttermilk and adjust the consistency. Finally, we'll add the entire buttermilk. And the amount of buttermilk that needs to be added is basically to get this consistency, which is looser than the chapati dough. So keep mixing it so that there are no lumps. So cover it and let it rest for 20 minutes. We will prepare the bread pan before we put it in the oven. So I'm just adding a few drops of oil. Sprinkling flour, wheat flour, and we will dust this. So we'll add some more wheat flour and we have to see that all the sides are uniformly dusted. We have rested the dough for 20 minutes, so now let's mix this again. And we'll transfer this to the baking pan. Dip your hands in water and then spread the dough. Now we'll add the sesame and spread it. The cumin. Take a teaspoon of oil and tap the bread. The application of oil on top of the dough is called glazing. So here the bread pan is ready to go into the oven. Before we bake our bread, let's preheat the oven at 180 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. And then we bake our bread at 180 degrees for half an hour. So here our whole wheat bread is baked. Let's take it out. Once you remove the bread from the oven, just check by poking whether it is cooked or not. Here, nothing is sticking, so it's cooked. Many of us are aware that maida is extremely unhealthy. But what I have discovered today is much more. Do keep watching to know more. Maida, also called refined white flour or all-purpose flour, has an unpleasant metaphor, glue of the gut. In recent years, maida is an integral part in baking industry. But the harmful effects of maida on our body are also well known. Maida is highly refined wheat flour. The refining process removes 95% of the fiber present in the bran and also many important nutrients like iron, magnesium, phosphorus, and various vitamins. Therefore, maida has a very high glycemic index and thus the sugar release happens in sudden spikes in the bloodstream. Long-term use of processed and refined foods produce inflammation, insulin resistance, and eventually leads to type 2 diabetes. But there is more. Did you know that a chemical called alloxan is used to bleach the maida to give its characteristic white color? Alloxan has been reported to induce diabetes by destroying the beta cells of pancreas that produce insulin. How bad can it get? Would you still like to use maida? For those who do not have an oven, let's see how to bake a bread in a kadhai. So let's heat the kadhai. And I'm going to be adding salt here. And if you have a metal stand, you could keep it on top of the salt. Here I'm having a plate, so I'm going to keep this plate on top of the salt. We will preheat the kadhai with the salt on a high flame for about 2 to 3 minutes and then get it on sim flame. And here goes our bread pan. We'll cover this with a plate and bake this on sim flame for at least 20 minutes and then we can check it. So let's see how far our bread has been baked here. It has risen but not yet done. So we'll wait for another 10 to 15 minutes. So here let's check whether our bread is baked. Looks baked, so we'll just test this. So we'll just prick this. Yeah, it's not sticking. It's taken me about 50 minutes to bake this bread. So the yardstick is every 15 minutes, you can just poke it and check whether it is cooked or not. I'm switching off the gas and we will let this cool before we turn it. So here, we can cool the salt. You can keep the salt exclusively for baking.
Isn't this a much better option than buying refined flour bread from the market?
So now let's remove the bread from the pan. It looks absolutely super. Let's cut our bread slices. Here's our homemade wholesome wheat bread. I'm going to have this with a scoop of butter and homemade banana jam. As man started to refine himself, he also started to refine his food. And today we have refined flour, refined oil, refined sugar, and refined salt. Just think of it. The so-called being progressive attitude is so deep-rooted in human society that today millets and jaggery is considered as a poor man's food. But today, among the urban health conscious, things are definitely changing, and there is a resurgence in the use of millets, jaggery, and other whole foods. But we have a long way to go. But today, modern science is proving beyond doubt that there's a strong link between refined food and lifestyle diseases. What can you do about it? Here are some tips. Go in for whole grain foods, whole flours, cold-pressed oil, and unrefined sweeteners. As a thumb rule, avoid something that is really white. Try and avoid the five white poisons: white rice, white sugar, white flour, refined oil, and refined salt. I have touched upon more aspects related to our health in one of my previous videos released on the eve of New Year 2020. What are your thoughts after watching this video? Are you inspired to use whole foods? And are you going to be making a wholesome whole wheat flour bread ASAP? Do share your thoughts in the comment section below. Stay home, stay safe, and eat healthy. Hey, have you subscribed to Munch & Mull? Do click on the subscribe button and press the bell icon to receive notifications of my newest videos uploaded every Saturday.